Hey guys, welcome back to This Woodwork. So this here is my latest creation. It's what I've called a router lathe, and it's really just an attachment for my lathe, which means I can recreate items like bud vases or table legs time and time again with pretty accurate precision, which is really handy for someone like me who, although I love my wood turning, I'm not really any good at recreating the same thing more than once. So when it comes to table legs, it's not going to work. So this really helps me out. It's based on the sort of principle which you get in commercial machines, where they have a router but it's computer numerically controlled and guided across the lathe. Now this is loosely sort of based on that kind of idea. So in the case of my router lathe, it works by following these sort of templates, which is the sort of profile of, in this case, a bud vase, but obviously it works with table legs and any manner of sort of between centre turnings rather than your sort of your bowls. And it, all that happens is it comes down here, it's mounted onto this piece, and then it can be followed by the guide pin, which directs the router bit. So now it's time to demonstrate the router lathe working by creating a bud vase. So the router lathe is at a point now where it is actually working, but it is by no means perfect. This is actually just the second time which I've tested it, so let's hope that all goes well. So I started by roughing it down between centres, and now I'm just removing it and reattaching it with a chuck. And then this is where the fun begins. This is pretty unstressful work because I'm just using a template to do all the thinking for me. So I just moved the router backwards and forwards, gradually getting deeper. So just before I route it down to its final shape, I drill the hole through the centre using a chuck attachment for the tailstock. So it seems that nothing is hand tool free, and at this point I'm just hollowing out the top of the vase very gently using a round nose scraper. This is just one of those jobs that you just can't really do using power tools. I then proceed to give the bud vase a thorough sanding. The router bit didn't leave as smooth a finish as I originally wanted. I began my sanding at 150 grit and worked my way up to about 800 to get a really smooth to the touch finish. So once the bud vase is sanded, I proceed to start the finishing process. I begin by applying a thin coat of sanding sealer. I then sand the sealer so that most of it is removed, so that it's only left in the deepest parts of the grain. I then burnish the surface of the wood using 4-ounce steel wool, which is going to prepare the surface for a dye, which is going to make this project a little bit more interesting. I'm going to use green and blue coloured dyes to create a really nice effect on the wood, and these are just trial size bottles, which I had laying around. So as you can see, I've started by applying the blue dye first,
By applying the dark colour underneath, it's going to help to give a really great depth of finish. Once the blue has dried, I then go on to apply a layer of green over the top. You can build up as many layers as you like to get the depth of colour which you're looking for. Once the dye had fully dried, I came back with 4-ounce steel wool again and burnished the surface. This allowed the fibres of the wood, which were penetrated deep enough by the sanding sealer beforehand, to show through, as they were not affected by the dye. I then apply another coat of sanding sealer in preparation for the lacquer finish. After the sanding sealer had dried, I then went on to apply a coat of lacquer. After that coat of lacquer had dried, I would burnish the surface again with steel wool and follow up doing the same for the further six or... Once the lacquer had dried, I could then polish the finish. I started by using steel wool and followed it up using a 4000 grit pad and finally buffed the finish using a piece of foam. Throughout all of this, I use a paste wax as a lubricant. And you can see the finish it creates. Now that the bud vase is finished, I can remove it from the lathe by cutting through the stub which I created at the bottom of the vase. I'm using a Japanese handsaw to do this. Once I've removed it from the lathe, I'll go on to sand the bottom smooth using a belt sander and sign and date it as I usually do. Once that's done, I then apply a small amount of finish to the base, and the vase is done. Obviously, if you're worried about dyeing the bottom, you can do that as well.
So here's the little bud vase that just came off the router lathe. It's quite nice, really. I haven't used that sort of technique before when it comes to staining it with sort of bright dyes like that. So that was fun to do, and hope you enjoyed seeing this router lathe in action. I'll see you again soon, guys. Bye-bye.